Hello friends, welcome to our new session, Plus 2 Commerce, lesson number 23, Elements of Entrepreneurship. Choose the correct answer. Which of the below is a factor of production? All the above is the answer. Entrepreneur is not classified as employee because entrepreneur is the owner of the business. What are the characteristics of the entrepreneur? All of this. Which of the below is not classified into managerial function, that is marketing? Next question. Which of the below is a commercial function, accounting? Very short answer question. Mention any two characteristics or features of entrepreneurs. Spirit of enterprise, self-confidence, flexibility, innovation. Any two points you can mention. Next question, list on the managerial function of entrepreneurs, planning, organizing, directing, controlling, and coordination. These are all the points. Third question, list on the promotional function of entrepreneurs. Promotional function of entrepreneurs. Discovery of idea. Determining the business objectives, detailed investigation, choice of form of enterprise, fulfillment of the formalities, preparation of business plan, mobilization of funds, procurement of machines and materials are the functions of entrepreneurs. What is meant by entrepreneur? What is meant by entrepreneur? Entrepreneur is one who thinks and acts like an entrepreneur for the firm's development during the course of employment in an organization. Entrepreneurs are usually employees of a company who are assigned to a particular project or who are assigned to work on a special idea. Next question, which has been asked in the March 2020 paper. List the challenges faced by the women entrepreneurs. Problem of finance, limited mobility, lack of education, lack of network support, stiff competition, sensitivity, lack of information, dependent culture. Next, move on to short answer. First question. Define entrepreneur. In the words of A.H. Cole, the purposeful activity of an individual or group of associated individuals undertaken to initiate, maintain, or earn profits by production and distribution of economic goods and services is known as entrepreneur or entrepreneur. Difference between entrepreneur and manager. So you can say entrepreneur, entrepreneur, anything you can say, but you have to write in the exam correct spelling. So basis of difference, entrepreneur and manager. Motive. The very motive of an entrepreneur is to start a venture by setting up an entity. The very motive of manager is to render service in an entity set up for execution of venture. Venture means work. Status. Entrepreneur is owner of the entity. Entity means company. Manager is a salaried employee in the entity set up for carrying on the venture. Risk bearing. Entrepreneur bears the eventual risk and uncertainty in operating the enterprise. Manager does not bear any risk in the venture. Where the venture is unsuccessful, he or she simply quits the enterprise. Next question. List down the commercial function of entrepreneur and explain them shortly, or explain the commercial function of entrepreneur. Both answers are same. First point, production or manufacturing. Under production function, Entrepreneur has to take decision relating to selection of factory site, design and layout, type of products to be manufactured, product design, etc. Marketing. Entrepreneur has to carry out following functions pertaining to marketing aspects, namely consumer research, product planning and development, standardization, packaging, pricing, warehousing, distribution, promotion, etc. So all this work should be done by entrepreneur. Accounting. Entrepreneur has to arrange to prepare trading and profit loss account in order to know the profit or loss incurred out of operation of the business, and prepare balance sheet to know the financial status of business at a particular day. So he must prepare the accounts to know the profit or loss of the business. Finance, which is very much needed in all the business. In the sphere of financial function, an entrepreneur has to take decision like choosing the right type of financing, framing the best dividend policy, acquiring of funds, etc. Human resource management. Entrepreneur has to estimate the manpower needs of the enterprise and accordingly decide the size of manpower required for various laws of organizational structure. So that is known as human resource management. So how many persons required to do the work, that has to be decided or planned before itself. Explain the promotional function of entrepreneur. Discovery of idea. The first and foremost function of entrepreneur is idea generation. Idea can be generated through several ways, like own experience and exposure of entrepreneur, keen observation and of environment, education, training, market survey, environmental scanning, and so on. So idea should be there before doing any work. Determining the business objectives. Entrepreneur has to develop business objectives in the backdrop of a nature of business and type of business activity. Example, nature of business, manufacturing or trading, etc. Detailed investigation. Entrepreneur has to analyze in detail the product proposes to produce. Choice of form of enterprise. Entrepreneur has to choose the appropriate form of organization suited to implement the venture. There are various forms of organization, namely sole proprietor, partnership, etc. Fulfillment of the formalities, preparation of business plan, mobilizing of funds, procurement of machines and materials are also some points. Now move on to long answer. First question. How do you classify entrepreneurs? Entrepreneurs as a risk bearer. The entrepreneur to be a person who assumes risk inherent in the venture started by him. Entrepreneur act as an agent combining all factors of production to produce a product or service in order to sell at uncertain price in future. An entrepreneur.
How do you classify entrepreneurs? Entrepreneur as a risk bearer. The entrepreneur to be a person who assumes risk inherent in the venture started by him. Venture means work. So entrepreneur is who owner of the business. He think that there is a risk when he is doing the business. Entrepreneur act as an agent combining all factors of production to produce a product or service in order to sell at uncertain price in future. An entrepreneur to be an economic functionary who undertakes the risk of uncertainty which cannot be insured or capitalized or salaried. So entrepreneur is a person who is taking all the risk of the business and he will do the business. Entrepreneur means like your father is doing a business, so he is known as entrepreneur. So entrepreneur as an organizer, you can say entrepreneur, entrepreneur. So entrepreneur as an organizer. So entrepreneur is one who bring together various factors of production and creates an entity to produce products or services and supervises and coordinates several functions in the process. He further elaborates that an entrepreneur faces a great deal of obstacles and misfortunes and undergoes mental agony and anxieties in the process of organizing any venture, means work. So entrepreneurs will look after the production function, supervise all the activities of the business and all the work of the business. Entrepreneur as an innovator. Innovator means new ideas. So entrepreneur is one who introduce a brand new product in the market. So he will introduce a new product in the market. Institutes new technology to produce a product. Discover new course of supply of raw materials. Discovers new product hitherto untapped. Puts in place a new form of organization by establishing a monopoly or by dismantling existing monopoly. Now move on to next question, second essay. What are the characteristics of an entrepreneur or features of entrepreneur? Both questions are same. Spirit of enterprises. Entrepreneur should be bold. So entrepreneur or entrepreneur should be bold enough to encounter risk arising from the venture undertaken. Entrepreneur should not get discouraged by setbacks or frustrations emerging during the course of entrepreneurial journey. So he must take all the risk. He should be aware and take care of the business. Flexibility. Entrepreneur should not single-mindedly stick to decision in a rigid fashion. Entrepreneur should change the decision made already in the light of ever-changing business environment. So you must not be rigid on your decision. You no need to be stick on decision as per the business condition or requirement of the market. You can change your decision. Now, innovation. What do you mean by innovation? Innovation means new ideas. So entrepreneur should contribute something new or something unique to meet the changing requirements of customers. Namely, he will change a new product, new method of production, of distribution, etc. Next, very important thing is hard work. Very important is hard work. For all the business or study or whatever it may be, hard work is compulsory. Hard work with discipline only, you will achieve everything in your life. So hard work is very important in business. Entrepreneur should put in tireless efforts and constant endeavors to accomplish the goals of the venture successfully. They have to courageously face uncertain risk and constraints. Now in 2 marks, in the board examination, they ask, what is analytical ability? Entrepreneurs should not make decision on the basis of own prejudice or personal likes and dislikes. So he will not purchase the goods or sold the goods according to his likes and dislikes. What entrepreneur will do? Entrepreneur should be able to objectively analyze the situation and act accordingly. Means as per the situation of the market and customer, he He'll purchase and sell the goods. Foresight. Entrepreneur should have a foresight to visualize future business environment. So he will take care of the business. If you want to improve your business, he has to take care the likes and dislikes of customers, clients. Difference between an entrepreneur and intrapreneur. This is very important question which has been asked in the March 2020 paper. Difference between entrepreneur and intrapreneur. Basis, thinking. Entrepreneur is a free thinker. Free thinker, who is this? Exactly, normal case, entrepreneur means sole trader. Your father is an entrepreneur. Entrepreneur means a businessman. Intrapreneur means employee of the company. Intrapreneur means employee of the company. An entrepreneur means sole trader, businessman, owner. So entrepreneur means owner and intrapreneur means employee. So entrepreneur is a free thinker. He can think whatever he like, he want. Entrepreneur is forced to think independently, but within scope of business activities undertaken in the enterprise. So he can think freely, he can think within some limits. Dependency. Entrepreneur is an independent person. Entrepreneur is a dependent on the entrepreneur, he is an employee. Understand? Fund mobilization. Fund means money. Entrepreneur has to mobilize funds to finance the venture. Means he has to arrange the fund to complete the work. Entrepreneur does not engage in fund mobilization but can access funds mobilized by the entrepreneur. So he doesn't want to mobilize the fund, engage in a fund mobilization. He only use the fund for the business purpose. He doesn't want to arrange. Reward. Entrepreneur is rewarded by profit for the risk-bearing exercise. So the sole trader, the businessman, will take the risk and get the profit. Sometime loss and sometime profit. But he is only rewarded, means benefited by profit, by taking risk, because business is risk. Entrepreneur does not share in profits of venture but gets perquisites, salary, incentive, etc. for the service. So he will not be get any profit, but he will get a good salary, good incentives if he do the very good work for the company, because company will improve, then only their salary will be improved. Risk bearing. Entrepreneur bears the risk involved in the venture undertaken. Entrepreneur does not bear any risk in the venture and does not even share the risk inherent in the project or work assigned. However, entrepreneur is accountable for the task or project assigned. Status. Entrepreneur is owner and does not report to anybody in the venture. Entrepreneur is a salaried employee. Entrepreneur works within control put in place in the organization and is made accountable for the activities undertaken. So, entrepreneur is an employee, salaried employee. He has some limit and he has to do according to that. Operation. Entrepreneur operates mostly outside the enterprise. Entrepreneur operates within the enterprise. So he can go outside and do all the works of the business, but he has to do the work within the enterprise. Next very important question which is asked in the March 2020 paper. Discuss the challenges faced by woman entrepreneur. Woman entrepreneur means the ladies or women, if they start the business, what are the problems they are facing. The first problem, problem of finance. Finance means money. You can say finance or finance. The access of women to external sources of funds is limited as they do not generally own properties in their own name. Financial institutions, they impose stringent condition which discourages women to avail themselves of loan assistance from banks. Because of the limited funds, women entrepreneurs are not able to effectively and efficiently run and expand their business. Because of lack of funds, they can't run the business properly. Limited mobility. Indian women cannot afford to shed their household responsibility towards their family even after they plunge into the venture started by them. This restricts the mobility of women entrepreneurs significantly. So, even if you are doing a business as you are a woman, you can't say that I will not do the household work. You must do the household work as well as the business. So, it is not easy for women to do both the work at a time. Lack of education. Illiterate and semi-literate women entrepreneurs encounter a lot of challenges in their entrepreneurial journey. With respect to maintaining accounts, understanding money matters, day-to-day operation of the company, etc., this is the efficiency of operating the business successfully. Now also, in India, there are so many illiterate or semi-literate women are there, run the business or maintain the accounts by themselves. It will take a lot of time to understand and do the work. So that is the problem faced by the women. Stiff competition, another point. Women entrepreneurs have to face serious competition for their goods from organized sector and from their male counterparts. Since they are not able to spend freely due to financial restrictions, they are not able to compete effectively in the market. So because of too much competition of the goods, it is very difficult to stay in the market. Lack of information. Women entrepreneurs are reported not to be generally aware of the subsidies and incentives available for them due to their poor literacy level or due to their preoccupation with household responsibility. So they have less information because they are not connected with the market. Dependent culture. In India, women, however educated and talented, are groomed to be dependent on their parents, life partners and children during the various phases of their life cycle. This culture barrier does not allow them to start and manage their venture according to their free will and pleasure. So now also in India, women are the life partners, they are living with the children and they have to look after household activities also. So it is very difficult to do the work individually or freely. Move on to next question, which is important also, which has been asked in the half-yearly exam. Explain in detail the various functions of entrepreneur. Promotional function, discovery of idea. The first and foremost function of entrepreneur is idea generation. Idea can be generated through several ways, like own experience and exposure of entrepreneur, keen observation of environment, education, training, market survey, environmental scanning, and so on. So this is the discovery of idea. So by seeing the environment, by seeing the education training, you will know about the new ideas. You can promote it. Determining the business objectives. Entrepreneur has to develop business objectives in the backdrop of nature of business and type of business activity, example, nature of business, manufacturing or trading, etc. Detailed investigation. Entrepreneur has to analyze in detail the product proposes to produce. Choice of form of enterprise. Entrepreneur has to decide or has to choose the appropriate form of organization suited to implement the venture. There are various forms of organization, namely sole proprietorship, partnership, etc. Fulfillment of the formalities, preparation of business plan, mobilization of funds, procurement of machine and materials. In all these 8 points, any 5 points or 3 points you can read, and next managerial functions you can write 3 points. So 3 points from that and 3 points from managerial functions. Managerial function, first point is planning. Without planning, you can't do any business. Planning. Entrepreneur has to lay down the objective, goals, vision, mission, policies, procedures, programs, budget, schedule, etc. for enabling the venture to proceed towards establishing destinations. Organizing. Entrepreneur puts in place suitable organizational structure to perform various managerial functions, namely defining and delegating authority, distributing responsibility and creating accountability for efficient performance of activities. So planning, organizing is very important. Now move on to directing. Entrepreneur has to motivate, lead, guide and communicate with subordinates on ongoing basis in order to accomplish preset goals. Controlling. Entrepreneur has to put in mechanism to evaluate the performance of employees across the organization. Coordination. Entrepreneur has to evolve mechanism to pull together diverse function performed by various departments or teams and direct them towards the established goals of organization for accomplishment. So coordination is very important. Both entrepreneur and employee join together and do the work, then only they can accomplish the goal. Move on to commercial function. Production or manufacturing. Under production function, entrepreneur has to take decision relating to selection of factory site, design and layout, type of products to be manufactured, product design, etc. Marketing. Marketing. Entrepreneur has to carry out following function pertaining to marketing aspect, namely consumer research, product planning and development, standardization, packaging, pricing, warehousing, distribution, promotion, etc. So marketing is a commercial function. Now move on to accounting. Entrepreneur has to arrange to prepare trading and profit and loss account in order to know the profit or loss incurred out of operation of the business, and prepare balance sheet to know the financial status of the business at a particular day. So account is very much important and needed. Finance means money. In the sphere of financial function, an entrepreneur has to take decision like choosing the right type of financing, framing the best dividend policy, acquiring of funds, etc. The last point, human resource management. Entrepreneur has to estimate the manpower needs of the enterprise and accordingly decide the size of manpower required for various slots of organizational structure. So up to this, our 23rd lesson is completed.